Good afternoon. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers of the conference for providing us this excellent platform to exchange our knowledge, ideas, some results of our work. European Institute for Gender Equality is a European agency established in Vilnius. It plays several very important functions. First of all, is to promote gender equality in the European Union, beyond, to combat discrimination based on sex, and also to increase public awareness about gender equality. We are working closely with very many different institutions, but probably the institutions that we're staying in the closest touch are EU institutions like European Commission and European Parliament, but we also work very closely with member states as well, also civil society organizations and civil partners and researchers as well. During this presentation, I would like to address an issue of the importance of monitoring the policies, of the evaluating of the actions taken, and actually because this is one of the very important prerequisites for the social change. If we take a look to the developments in Europe since 1957, I just would like to mention just a few policies. They're very important, but not all of them mentioned in the slide. We'll probably have to admit that we have quite an impressive list of different policies in the area of gender equality and also legislative proposals. But the problem is that not all of them have very clearly established targets or benchmarks that we could monitor and assess the progress in those fields. Because in policies themselves, we probably have to admit that those different articles of aims and objectives that are set, they are quite okay. If it comes to other areas, the targets are more or less clear. They drive also the collection of data. Economic statistics is very well elaborated. If we need the data on this and that, it's quite easily accessible and it's available. When it comes to gender equality, we have let's say, formulations like to combat violence against women, to improve gender in research content, or other kind of language, which is very difficult actually, because there are no targets, no benchmarks, and it's very difficult to assess what does it mean to combat, what does it mean to improve. And of course, if we set up a targets, if we set up benchmarks, then there has to be data available to monitor the development. In the area of gender equality, we're facing a problem of data and quality of data, because what happens is that statistics very often is disaggregated by sex at the very end of the process. And it's just a few surveys, if derive you at all, where gender is mainstream from the very beginning of the development of the concept and questionnaire. So this is the problem that I would like to start from, and saying that it's very, very important to have explicit targets in national and institutional policies to improve gender balance in research. And of course, then to have action plans how to reach those targets with very, very clearly established actions, responsible people, budget allocated to that, timeframes, and other important indicators. It's also important to mention that gender issues must become an integral part of evaluation of institutions, external, internal, and for that, of course, we also need to collect data and to have a full picture. How do we monitor the progress of gender equality in Europe? It's just one example that I would like to present to you. It's quite, we're very proud of it. So last year, we launched a gender equality index for the European Union. The index was already mentioned in the documents of the previous roadmap for gender equality of 2006 and 2010. Then it was reintroduced again in a new strategy. An institute finally took over this task, and it took several years to build an index for Europe. You will ask, why another index? We have several global ones. Yes, we have several global ones, but the problem is that Europe ranks very high there, and the differences between countries are completely invisible. Of course, we needed something which is more targeted to European context, which is more targeted to our problems and our priorities. to do that, we needed a very, very operational, very pragmatic definition. We know that in the European Union, gender equality is defined as it takes this twofold approach, its specific measures to improve the situation of underrepresented gender and gender mainstreaming. But of course, from index point of view, we needed something what is very, very operational, what is measurable. And we define gender equality as an equal share of assets, an equal dignity and integrity between women and men. The second part of the definition, it more refers to violence against women issues. And what index is measuring? It's measuring gender gaps adjusted to levels of achievement. If in certain countries nowadays we do not have gender gaps, but the situation is equally bad for women and men, like unemployment rates, it's not what we are looking for. We are looking for at zero gender gaps, but high levels of achievement as well. So, as I mentioned, it's a tool, it's a monitoring tool, which is very well adjusted to the European context. The principles that guided our work, they come from the work of the European Commission and namely JRC and OECD together. There was developed this handbook on, and it's not very straightforward exercise, because for that you have to, there are very, very important also statistical principles that you have to follow. And here is the whole conceptual framework. And at this point in my presentation, I'd like to mention is that index is not based on specific sectors. You won't see the research as such, the research area in the index. Of course, it's quite, it is kind of hidden under these more general domains, which actually, as you see here, they touch the problems of more general nature, like the area of work, where we talk about participation in general, segregation, quality of work, or domain of money, where the issues of pay gap are touched, or the issues of economic situation, then domain of power, knowledge, time and health. The data about people participating or working, employed in the research sectors is there. The data on earnings of people is also there. The data on segregation is also there. But of course, it is not, you cannot find them in a very straightforward way. But I will talk later in my presentation how actually research, the data from the research area could become more visible, how we could use it more in our further analysis. The titles in red, they show that the data is not available in these areas, because gender equality index is not bound to data, to just available data. The concept is that it's broader, because gender equality index also aims to point to the data gaps. For example, the area of violence is very, very problematic, because we don't have comparable data for Europe. It's all intersecting inequalities, which touches upon issues of going beyond gender, also looking to other differences. The problem is that besides gender and age, it's very little is actually available that we could use. Okay, now just a few, before I start proposing something, I would like to draw attention to several factors which are very also relevant when we think about what could be included, what could be used. The thing is that in Europe we don't have a survey on gender equality. It means that if you don't have a survey for that, you use data from different surveys which have different time and country coverage, they have different samples, they include different populations. And gender equality index is about, taking certain variables they have to load to each other together, and it's not that simple. And when you use very different surveys, sometimes you have to disregard certain variables which you might think that they are important, but unfortunately they don't fit to this framework. And we're also focusing on individuals, not on institutions, on outcome variables, not on income. For example, input variables. For example, if we think about expenditure, yes, expenditure is important, but what is more important is that what the real impact it makes on individual women and men. Investment, yes, we can spend a lot of money for this and that, but finally, at the end of the day, what is the outcome of this investment and how it impacts the real situation of women. That's why we decided that we focus on that. And of course, when we think further about now integrating research area into this index, it's actually, again, we will have to think about not to mix, actually, because it has to stay at the level of outcome variables. Okay, so these are the domains, the main domains which I mentioned. This is within the core, violence and intersecting inequalities. They stay separately because they approached a little bit differently from different perspective. Here we have an index for Europe. This is aggregate for all domains, aggregate score. And you see that the EU average is 54. The interpretation of index is simple. It's from 1 to 100. So we are halfway. We are halfway in, after these more than 50 years of those policies that I started my presentation with, we are still halfway. If I take 4 Scandinavian countries and Netherlands from the index, the EU average drops even below that. So, because as you see, there are 4 countries which are quite driving the score up. So this is the room for improvement. The domains which are the most problematic are domains of power, women and men, involvement in decision making, and domain of time. Time because of very unequal share of time in caring and household duties. Okay, now what further analysis we made with the index, because it allows very interesting analysis to correlate it with other social indicators or variables. And we chose actually area for our small analysis. It's not published yet, it's still in the process. I just wanted to show you a few slides as an example, what can be done, how we can use this index. We chose the area of innovation, and for example, we correlated it with this percentage of GDP spending on research and development. And here you see a very large difference, first of all, among the countries, with as little as 0.5% in Romania and Cyprus, to nearly 8 times as much, 3.9% in Finland. And there is a very strong positive association between this percentage of spending and levels of gender equality. Okay, so we see the countries like Finland, Sweden, Denmark, they're high on both scores, GDP spending on research and also gender equality. If you ask me what impacts what, the answer is not that easy. Is it gender equality driving? Is it spending on research driving? It's not that easy, but that we just conclude that there is a strong positive relationship. We also correlated with the Summer Innovation Index. Same, the Summer Innovation Index, which measures the extent to which ideas from innovative sectors are able to reach the market, providing better jobs and making Europe more competitive. And here as well, we have a very difference, big differences between countries, which scores ranging between 23 out of 100 in Bulgaria, 73 for Sweden. And there is, again, very strong positive correlation between that. We did many more very interesting analysis with the indicators related to, for example, to other, with indicators from other areas of employment, education, and so we found very, very interesting analysis, actually, how different sectors, they actually benefit from gender equality. Gender equality pays off, or it's very costly if you don't actually work on it. So this is just a few examples to share with you. And now I would like to come to this point and to think a little bit and tell you that the work, what I will present you now, is just it's very much in this initial phase of thinking how actually we could use this index to have a bit more kind of attention to different sectors, and one of the sectors would be research and innovation. One of the ways is that to expand analysis within existing framework. This is the easiest way to go. Existing framework, I showed it to you, repeat it again. This is what exists. What we do, we just extract some data which is more applies to the research sector. For example, in the domain of power, it's the social domain, subdomain, which is in the middle. It's actually very much about heads of research institutions, maybe boards of national science councils, and other decision-making bodies. that we could take it, extract and analyze here. Within the domain of knowledge, at the moment, master's, PhDs are merged together. We can separate them. We can analyze a little bit what are the attainment. There, we can maybe analyze also segregation. And in the domain of time, we could withdraw and analyze the work-life balance issues in the, that researchers are facing and time spent on. And in the domain of violence here, there will be an issues of sexual harassment in institutions, indirect form of violence, or relates to norms and perceptions and attitudes that people have that indirectly contribute to the prevalence of violence. Option two is a bit more, it will require more work. Myself personally, I find it is a more relevant, more interesting, and I think it would be probably more, could add more to the sector itself if we apply it. Then it means that research becomes an area, a focus of analysis in itself. Now the aspects that I added here, they come from GenSet recommendations to focus on knowledge making, on human capital, practices, processes, regulation, and compliance. And there, the sector itself becomes a focus of analysis. We focus on the issues that are particular to that particular sector. And then, of course, then we can correlate with gender equality, with the core, because there would be many possibilities how to connect this sectorial approach with the core of the index. And that from there, we could really have a very focused and very, this would very much add actually to the work on institute, which we are planning in the nearest future to start in the area of gender mainstreaming in research, more on national level. So this is the option that we will also consider. And of course, in the sectorial approach, we'll have to keep in mind also the three main objectives of the Horizon 2020, gender balance in decision making, research teams, gender dimension in research and innovation content. And in a way, it could contribute also to the creating benchmarks that we could actually use them to monitor the implementation of Horizon 2020 in the future. The potential data sources are Eurostat, but also several surveys which are carried out by the DG Research and Innovation with no SHE figures. But we also know that there is a research performing organization survey, research funding organization survey. So yes, working together with our partners there, we could actually use this data to accommodate. And I mentioned several potential indicators in the table, but of course these are just several examples because much more than that will be needed. Okay, so to conclude my presentation, in order to promote a structural change, first of all, we need to have a knowledge. We have to have a knowledge about the situation in the institution. We have to collect data, develop statistics in order to be able to monitor the situation, to monitor the trend, to see how those policy objectives or, I don't know, some actions which are set up in gender equality plans in organizations, how they are implemented, what is the outcome of that. Of course, it's very important to secure top-level support for those actions because we know very well that without the support of leadership, it would be very, very, very hard to do something. And, of course, implement gender mainstreaming if it's according to how it's defined and in its real sense. And here is the gender equality index is presented in a very interactive interface on Institute's webpage. And there you can find many more information and materials. The Institute also has a very rich resource and documentation center, and these are accessible through our homepage and all those resources and all information regarding that. And we are also, we'll be very happy if you also send us ideas or comment on our work, maybe personally also after the conference. Thank you very much.